Welcome to a lesson on graphing a quadratic function in general form using symmetric points. To get an idea of how this method works, let's look at the graph of a quadratic function. These two black points are symmetric points on the quadratic function because they're mirror images of one another across the red vertical line, which is the axis of symmetry. So the idea is, if we can find two symmetric points on the parabola, then we know the axis of symmetry would have to pass through directly in between the two points, allowing us to also find the x-coordinate of the vertex, and therefore finding the corresponding y-coordinate as well from the function. So looking at our graph, notice how this point has coordinates 0, negative 1, and this point has coordinates 4, negative 1. Symmetric points on a parabola will always have the same y-coordinates, and if we take the average of the x-coordinates, we can find the equation of the axis of symmetry. Here, 0 plus 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. So the equation of the axis of symmetry is x equals 2, which means the x-coordinate of the vertex will also be 2. And then we can find f of 2 to find the y-coordinate of the vertex. So before we define the formal steps for this method, let's take a look at an example. So we can write this as y equals x squared minus 4x plus 3. And now for this method, we're going to factor out the greatest common factor between these two x terms here, which in this case, the greatest common factor is x. So now we'll write this as y equals x times the quantity x minus 4, and then we still have this plus 3. So to find those two symmetric points, we're going to find the x values that make this product here equal to 0. So let's make a table of values. If x is equal to 0, this product would be 0. And if x is equal to 4, x minus 4 would be 0, and therefore this product would be 0. So we'll select x equals 4 for the second x coordinate. Now we'll find the corresponding y values. When x is 0, this product is 0, so y is equal to 0 plus 3, or 3. And when x is 4, this factor is equal to 0. Therefore, this product is equal to 0, so y is still 0 plus 3, or 3. Again, notice how the y-coordinates are the same. Therefore, these will be symmetric points across the axis of symmetry. So we have the point 0, 3, which would be here. We have the point 4, 3, which would be here. And now we know the axis of symmetry must pass in the middle between these two points. So the axis of symmetry would be this vertical line here. Notice how the equation of this vertical line is x equals 2. And because the vertex is on this axis of symmetry, we know the x-coordinate of the vertex must be 2. So that'll be our third point. And now we'll evaluate the function at x equals 2. So f of 2, we'll go ahead and use the original function. So we'll have 2 squared minus 4 times 2 plus 3. So f of 2 is equal to 4, this would be minus 8 plus 3. So 4 minus 8 plus 3 is equal to negative 1. So our y-coordinate is negative 1 for the vertex. So we'll go ahead and plot this point. 2, negative 1 is here. And now notice this is more than enough information to make a nice sketch of our quadratic function. It would look something like this. So let's go ahead and formalize these steps. We'll start by factoring out the greatest common factor of the two x terms, and then we'll select the x values that make the factored part equal to 0. Then we'll find the corresponding y values. This will give us the two symmetric points, so we'll plot these two points. Then we'll determine the x value between the two points, which would give us the equation of the axis of symmetry. This will be the x-coordinate of the vertex. We'll find the corresponding y value, and then plot the vertex. And then from here we can graph the function. Let's take a look at two more examples. Again, let's start by replacing f of x with y. So we'll have y equals negative 2x squared plus 6x minus 1. And now we'll factor out the greatest common factor of these two x terms. The greatest common factor here would be 2x. But let's go ahead and factor out negative 2x. So we'll have y equals negative 2x times the quantity x minus 3. The sign's going to change here, then we still have minus 1. And now we'll select the values that make this product here equal to 0. So when x is 0, this factor is equal to 0. And when x is 3, this factor is equal to 0. So now we'll find the corresponding y values. When x is 0, this product is 0, so y is 0 minus 1, or negative 1. When x is 3, this is 0, therefore this product is 0 again, so y is equal to 0 minus 1, or negative 1. These two y coordinates should always be the same if we select the correct x values. Let's go ahead and plot these. We have 0, negative 1, and 3, negative 1. Now we should recognize the axis of symmetry would be this vertical line here, halfway between these two points, which would be x equals 1.5 or x equals 3 halves. Notice 3 halves is the average of the two x coordinates here. This also tells us the x coordinate of the vertex is 3 halves. So now we'll find f of 3 halves to find the y coordinate of the vertex. So f of 3 halves is going to be equal to negative 2 times 3 halves squared plus 6 times 3 halves minus 1. So this is going to be 9/4. So negative 2 over 1 times 9/4 plus 6 over 1 times 3 halves minus 1. This simplifies here, this simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. So this is going to equal negative 9 halves. This simplifies as well, this simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 3. So plus 9 and then minus 1. This is the same as negative 4.5. Negative 4.5 plus 9 is positive 4.5. Minus 1 is 3.5, which as a fraction would be 7 halves. And again, if it's helpful to plot this, we could think of this as the point 1.5 comma 3.5, which would be this point here. We should notice this parabola does open down, which is good because the leading coefficient is negative. So our graph looks something like this. And now let's take a look at one more example. First step, let's replace f of x with y. And now we'll factor out the greatest common factor from these two x terms, which in this case is just going to be x. So we'll have y equals x times the quantity 1 half x minus 1 minus 2. Now we'll make our table of values. This product here is going to be 0 when x is 0. But also when 1 half x minus 1 equals 0. So we'd add 1 to both sides of the equation, multiply both sides by 2. This simplifies to x, so x equals positive 2 for the second x coordinate. Now we're going to find the corresponding y values. When x is 0, this product here is 0, so we have y equals 0 minus 2, or negative 2. And when x is 2, this is 0, so we have y equals 0 minus 2, or negative 2 again. Let's go ahead and plot these two points. 0, negative 2, our y-intercept, and 2, negative 2 here. We should recognize the axis of symmetry is going to be this vertical line right between the two points with an equation of x equals 1, which means the vertex must have an x-coordinate of 1. So now we'll find the corresponding y value or the y coordinate of the vertex by determining f of 1, which would be 1 half times 1 squared minus 1 minus 2. It's going to be 1 half minus 1, that's negative 1 half minus 2, that's negative 2 and a half, or negative 5 halves, which is the same as negative 2.5. So the vertex has coordinates 1, negative 2.5, which would be here. Now these three points are pretty close together, so we may want to find one more point on this parabola. Let's evaluate the function at x equals 4. Four squared is 16. 16 times 1 half is 8. 8 minus 4 minus 2 is positive 2. So if f of 4 is equal to 2, that means the parabola would contain the point 4, 2, which would be this point here. And there's a symmetric point on the other side of the axis of symmetry, which would be this point here. Now we can make a nice sketch of our parabola. It would look something like this. Okay, I hope you find this method helpful. One thing nice about this method is you don't have to memorize any special formulas.